Winnie's up.
Where are you going?
Where are you off to?
There's no stopping him.
He's a very cheeky wee boy. He's extremely social.
But when it's time for a nap, baby Arlo is out like a light.
And he does sleep well, thankfully. one of the lucky ones.
That luck changed for the Hawker family a month ago when Mum Emily discovered something on the underside of Arlo's cot. Mould, and lots of it.
And I felt sick to my stomach and sort of just was in shock. I couldn't believe what I was seeing.
They bought the cot from Mocka, a New Zealand furniture company based in Otatahi, Christchurch.
We'd heard about their package deals and how they were really reasonably priced.
Before finding the Mould, Emily saw an article back in April about Mocka cots in Australia having the same issue.
Aussie's consumer watchdog, the ACCC, said it would do its own investigation and put the call out to Mocka customers to check their cots immediately, and if mould is found, to stop using the cot and contact Mocka Australia as well as the ACCC.
At the time, Mocka said that the issue appeared to be isolated to Australia.
It clearly wasn't. Emily spread the word in Aotearoa. The mould was also spreading. To the Millers in Oamaru, and to the Williams family in Cambridge. And according to Emily, to at least 40 other families around the country who got in touch with her on Facebook, all had mould in the same place, on the base of their cots. Most of Mocka's cot bases are made from a material called MDF, medium density fibreboard. It's commonly used in furniture and in kitchen cabinets because of its versatility and durability. So why was mould showing up on the bases of this particular batch of product?
In my opinion, it's got to do with the environment as well as the product.
We'll get to that soon. But first...
You've never done that before.
While we were there, baby Tawhiri Matea stood on his own for the first time.
He's doing it for the camera, eh?
Mum Natalia is one of the parents who saw Emily's Facebook post.
I thanked her for posting it or else I would have never checked.
She admits the mould on her son's cot was nowhere near as advanced as some others, but she was still concerned.
And I checked and I seen like little dots and stuff, so I wasn't quite sure. I took photos and then I checked back in the morning, but it was definitely mould.
Tawhiri Matea now sleeps with Natalia, and that brings its own challenges.
I have to freak out all the time that he's going to fall out of bed or he's going to, you know, cover his face or something. It's really hard, especially because, you know, I'm a young parent and I have two kids. I don't have the money where I can just go buy a new cot.
Fortunately, the Hawkers and the Williams families got full refunds from Mocka. The families bought new cots from another brand. But Dion thinks Mocka New Zealand could have done more to warn people.
I was pretty upset because they'd sort of offered a bit of reassurance through their social media platforms overseas that the issue was limited to really wet areas in Australia.
The Williams got rid of the cot straight away. They believe it was making their daughter Adeline sick.
She went to the doctor and she was prescribed antibiotics for a possible chest infection. Yeah, well, you think about a little baby's face against a mattress, they're only, you know, 4 or 5 inches from the actual source of the mould. So to have her lying in bed for upwards of, you know, say she's 14 months old for, say, 14 hours a day, you know, breathing that in, you can't say it's not related.
All the families we've spoken to believe there's a link between the mould and their children's prolonged illnesses, a link that's hard to prove. The World Health Organisation, though, is concerned that mould causes respiratory illness.
I spoke to the doctor and I said, look, is this mould exposure? What does mould exposure look like? And he sort of just said, you know, it could definitely be a contributor, but we can't prove that without doing intrusive tests.
Mocka has since put out a public statement saying it had its cots independently tested and the results found that the Mocka cot materials were not responsible for mould growth. But it's environmental factors, like changes in ventilation and air moisture, that are to blame. Mark Bigelar thinks it's a little more complicated than that.
Well, in my opinion, it's got to do with the environment as well as the product. I see a lot of MDF that I've shown you here as such that has been around for years in the damp and everything, and it hasn't done anything like that.
That's 50 years of furniture experience talking. Mark's a timber guy, but says MDF is reliable too.
It's not going to split or crack or warp and all that sort of thing, whereas solid timbers can.
Except when it's not treated or sealed with something to keep the moisture out.
Particularly on the edges, if you're using it in a, let's say, a kitchen, and you don't seal the door or paint it, as soon as the water drips on it, goes down the door, it'll just suck in to the bottom, you know, like Weet-Bix.
He suspects that might be the case with the MDF on Mocka's cots, but without proper testing, there's no way to tell.
If you have a look around the edges with the solid pine framing, that's actually in good condition, so, you know, there's something about the MDF that's not quite right.
Mark thinks proper testing of that batch of particular MDF board is the key. We put the suggestion to Mocka that maybe it's a batch issue, but they didn't respond.
They had done testing, but where's the evidence of this testing? What environments have you tested in? Have you tested with a baby in a cot who produces body heat?
Right. And what about the environmental factors?
Ever since he was born, we've had an oil heater either in our room when he was with us. We've had a dehumidifier in there at times. His room is well ventilated.
It's the same story for the others.
Her room was double glazed about 3 years ago. Only issue with any mould was the Mocka cot.
Fairgo asked Mocka about its MDF material, how it was tested, and what it plans on doing about the cots.
Since we first received inquiries, we instantly prioritised resolving them. All Mocka products, including cots, adhere to the current mandatory and voluntary safety requirements in Australia and New Zealand. All MDF used in Mocka furniture complies with strict regulations for household use. If it was found that the cot materials and design were responsible for supporting any mould growth, we would, of course, recall the products. We want to reiterate that our customers and the safety of their families is of absolute importance, and we will continue to encourage any concerned customers to contact us.
The Ministry of Business, Innovation and Employment and the ACCC have confirmed that a recall on the product isn't needed. Although Emily and Dion both got full refunds, and Mocha's working with Natalia on hers.
What these families want is more accountability from Mocka.
And I can guarantee you there'll be people around New Zealand with babies, similar age, with the same issue that they don't even know about.
At the end of the day, I'd love for the company to address the issue, to perhaps change their design, change the materials they've used, and just do something about it.